Mr. and Mrs. North, starring Barbara Britton and Richard Denning.
Supposed to do, keep my eyes shut.
Of course not, darling. I want you to enjoy the wonders of nature. But I'm afraid I have bad news for you.
What?
Well, that particular subject of your nature study is a girl I met in the beauty parlor this morning. Her name's Smith. Miss Smith.
What's the bad news?
Well, I believe she said that she has a ticket for the night plane to Havana. And we're leaving on the night train from New York.
Say what again?
The Northern Flyer now leaving for New York via Palm Beach, Jacksonville, Atlanta, Washington, and Baltimore. Board!
See, Jerry, I told you we had plenty of time.
Sure, we must have 30 seconds to... Look out, Pam!
Oh, sorry! Why, Miss Smith, I thought that you were... Oh, I am sorry.
Come on, darling, it's none of our affair.
Say, what is this, a gag?
It's okay, Polly. You can take the cuffs off her now.
I thought you were a cop.
She is, sweetheart. My cop. $50 a day in expenses.
You mean you had me kidnapped right out of my hotel?
Why, no, honey. Not kidnapped. We're eloping. You and me and a couple of reliable witnesses. Romantic, isn't it?
You and I, we're getting married?
Yeah, as soon as this train hits a certain town. And little old Georgia, it's all arranged.
Oh, is it all arranged? I don't remember anybody asking me about it.
Knew there was something I forgot. Well, how about it?
I'll give you a quick answer. No, I wouldn't marry you.
I'm not asking you, I'm telling you. That federal grand jury up in New York is going to hand down a criminal indictment sometime in the next 24 hours. It'll say something about income tax evasion on the part of Frank Bonner, bookmaker. Got that?
I was already here in Miami with plane tickets to Cuba. What
Shut up. The treasury men will pick you up wherever you went.
I won't talk, Frank. Really, I...
I know. Not when we're Mr. and Mrs. Bonner. Wife can't be made to testify against her husband.
Very neat. Did Laughing Boy figure this out for you?
Ernie does my bookkeeping. I do my own thinking. You're just lucky I'm not the old-fashioned type.
I'm a lucky kid, all right.
You said it. Because there are other ways of making sure you don't talk out of turn. An old-fashioned guy would have thought of them first.
But, we don't have to worry about that. Do we, honey?
I don't understand you at all, Jerry North. You were interested enough in that girl back at the hotel.
Hmm? Who?
That girl. Miss Smith. The one in the next compartment with that old battle axe. Back at the hotel, you could hardly take your eyes off of her, remember?
I'm a fickle type. Once I see those hard little lines around a girl's mouth and those hard little bracelets around her wrists, romantic notions fly out the window.
I don't understand any part of it. Miss Smith told me she was taking the plane for Havana, so why is she here on this train?
Well, from the looks of her companion in those handcuffs, I'm sure she isn't on the train by her own choice. And that's as far as I go.
But, Jerry, why?
Why what?
Why was she brought on this train in handcuffs?
Oh, I left my crystal ball back in Miami. Now, look, darling. All we know about your Miss Smith is that she has a very unlikely name.
A lot of people are named Smith.
Too many people who want to lose their real identity temporarily. But aside from that, your Miss Smith was about to leave the country. Now, it would appear she's been arrested. Does this suggest anything to you?
A famous international spy.
Oh.
I'll bet that's the answer. Just think, Jerry, a regular Matahari. And she stayed in the same hotel with us, and now she's in the next compartment on the train. Oh, Jerry, isn't that romantic?
Did you ever hear of James X. Bachelor?
A bachelor?
Hmm.
No.
I never did either. He's got a story in this magazine. It's great. It's a raw, lean style of writing. Hard-hitting, masculine. Strictly a young Hemingway.
Where are you going?
Find the conductor and get a rocket off to my secretary. I want a book from that man. Why don't you get us a table? I'll meet you in the diner as soon as I've sent this wire.
Your bride-to-be is hungry.
Okay. Ring for the porter to get some food in here.
Well, why can't we eat in the diner?
Because I like it in here.
Oh, stop. I'll behave. You don't want me to get that cooped-up feeling before we're married.
If you ask me, Frank, it makes us look more legitimate. You know, everything open and above board.
Who asked you?
Okay. You'll be a good girl. We won't get you dessert.
Now I know just how John Sutter must have felt.
Who, dear?
Sutter, the man who discovered gold in California.
Oh.
You're still brooding about that mystery woman in the next compartment. Oh, you're hopeless, darling. I know it's a romantic idea, but... The cloak and dagger lady just came in.
Sit against the window. Sit in a moment.
Maybe brook trout? Why don't you get the waiter?
Would you tear up the slip?
Oh, I changed my mind about the trout.
Did you have to tear up the slip?
Oh, let's not make a big thing of it. Get me another slip.
Give her another tab, please.
If I can just bring out a book by this man Bachelor, it'll be the literary gold mine of the decade.
That'll be nice.
Pam. Pam.
Yes, dear?
I think you better use this, unless you're planning to lick your fingers.
Oh, what's the matter with me?
Yeah, sure. What's the matter, dear?
I just went down the wrong way. I'm all right. Jerry, I don't feel very hungry. Do you mind taking me back to the compartment?
Oh, of course, dear.
Excuse me.
I'm in trouble, and what do you have to say about that?
Oh, now take it easy, darling. If she were in some sort of immediate danger, all she had to do was yell for help. The dining car was full of people.
Well, maybe they were holding a gun on her.
A 50 caliber machine gun concealed in one of the stuffed olives? No, Pam. The odds are she's got a wheel loose somewhere. Just wants attention. It's a very common psychosis. Oh, she's entitled to our sympathy, but...
Sympathy, my foot. We've got to find out what's wrong and help her.
Now, look, Pam, we can't... Yes,
Gerald North. A wire for you, sir.
Oh, thank you. Oh, no.
Something wrong, dear?
You're good at mysteries. See what you can make out of that.
Dear boss, contacted bachelor's agent. Stop. Nothing but double talk. Stop. No address or info on bachelor. Stop. Is this guy for real? Susan. I don't know what to think, Jerry.
Well, that's a refreshing admission.
You're Gerald North, the book publisher. The conductor said you were. I tipped him.
Oh, well, that's nice. And who are you?
Opal Crump. I hope I can talk with you for a moment.
Stand there, Jerry. Invite Mrs. Crump in. Or is it Miss?
Miss? Mr. North, I've written a book.
Well, that's wonderful, Miss Crump. I'd like to talk to you about it, but I have a very important wire I want to get off at the next stop. If you'll excuse me.
Hurry back. Oh, he's nice.
While Frank's saving a cigar, I want to have a talk with you.
A talk? About what?
There's a way out of this, you know.
What? What did you say?
I could help you get away. I'd turn Frank in. He'd die in prison. I can even arrange that.
You? You would double-cross Frank?
For you, I would, Monica. I've always loved you, Monica. Why do you think I've hung around and covered up for Frank's shady deals?
For money?
No, for you. I've thought, if only she were in trouble, if I could help her, if only I had enough money.
Stop right there, Junior. Without Frank, you couldn't make a fast 100.
I know a man who'll pay me 100 G's to testify against Frank. We could get married. We could go away to South America, to Europe, just the two of us.
Just the two of us. Mr. and Mrs. Wright. No thanks. Thanks, no prize. But at least he's a man.
But Monica...
Don't touch me. You'll make my flesh crawl.
Monica. You...
And that's how we spent our vacation.
I can't imagine what could be keeping Jerry so long, Miss Crump.
That's all right, dear. Don't worry about me.
But perhaps I'd better go find him.
I understand how it is with you young people. You can't bear to be apart. Tell Mr. North I'll call on him at his office in New York. And it's been nice talking to you. Thank you, dear.
It's been a pleasure, Opal.
Thank you.
you give me any trouble.
What's this all about?
The girl in the next compartment, she's been murdered. I found her on the floor of their room. If anyone's going to be put under arrest, it should be her. She's been impersonating an officer. Why, you little...
Now, you just take it easy, ma'am. We'll find out about this. All right, folks, let's keep the door clear.
Remember Bill Bargan telling us that officers only carry revolvers? Well, she was carrying an automatic, and that's how I knew she was a phony.
All right, darling. Now, let's get back to the murdered girl.
Well, I thought I heard some strange noises coming from this compartment, so I came out to investigate. And I knocked, and there was no answer. So I shoved the door a little like this, and it opened, and I... What have you done with her?
We've done with who? What is she talking about? What are you doing here?
Mister, we caught your friend holding a gun on this lady. And Mrs. North, she says there was a dead woman in your compartment.
Well, I saw her. She was lying right there. Tell them you were here.
It's your story. You tell it.
Well, now, just a second. If there was no body, what was that business with the gun and all that talk about arresting my wife?
I caught her snooping around in here, and I thought I'd teach her a lesson.
Are you, Miss?
I am.
Well, you got my deepest sympathy, but can't you keep in your own compartment?
Oh, now look here. You can't be... I'm sorry we disturbed you, Mr. Bonner. It won't happen again, sir.
But I tell you what...
Yes, ma'am. It'll be all right. You just take it easy now.
Hey, mister. My gun.
I wonder where she is.
That's a good question. And I'm interested in the answer. If you'd done anything to her...
I'll... never laid a finger on her.
And where is she? You're supposed to be watching. This is a double-cross unit screwball next door cooked up.
Yes, Polly. Who are you working for?
I told you, I don't know anything. She sent me to the club car to look for you. You weren't there. When I got back here, that North woman was in the room.
You're lying. Where are you hiding, Monica? I'll give you just 10 seconds to talk.
Stay away from me. You killed her, and I know what that makes me. I'm not going to be your patsy, Mr. Bonner.
outside on the tracks. I saw a snake in here.
What do you want, Ernie? Ernie.
Die, Jerry.
What are you doing in there?
I'm arranging a future for Mr. Bonner. I'm Treasury. Followed Bonner down to Florida and back. After I passed him up, I thought I'd see what I could do for the taxpayers. This evidence should keep Mr. Bonner out of circulation for quite a while.
Newark, next stop, Pennsylvania Station.
Jerry, I'll never get this thing closed.
Here, let me see what I can do. I don't understand. We didn't have any trouble with this bag at the hotel. What are you doing? Stealing blankets from the Pullman Company?
Jerry, what a thing to say. Of course not.
Well, let's see. What is it? What's this? And where did it come from?
Well, Jerry, you
see... Don't tell me. I know that sweet little old lady, Miss...
Miss Croft.
Yeah. Oh, how can you do this to me? You know I haven't got time to read every ambitious amateur's crosswinds. It must be 1,000 pages. I ought to make you read it. I hope Miss Crump thought to put her address in it so we can mail it back to her. Crosswinds by James X. Batchelor, Opal Crump of... James X. Batchelor?
Opal told me that's her pen name.
You darling, you sweetheart, you ever-loving little gold mine.
Yes, he's here. We just walked in the door. It's your office, Susan.
Huh?
Oh, yes, Susan, we had a wonderful trip. He just took his coat off. Thank you.
That's right. Oh, we had a ball. Of course, the curl in the next compartment on the train was hurted, but I guess that's about par for the North. What's on your mind? Oh. Oh, I see. Well, thank you very much, Susan, for the information. I'll make it in this afternoon.
Something wrong?
Yeah. Susan just located Francis X. Batchelor. He's a patient at the Walter Reed Hospital in Washington, D.C. Which brings up a very interesting question. How did his name get on this manuscript?
Well, you see...
Come on, Pam. Give. I want to know whose idea it was to give Opal Crump a pen name. This particular name.
Mine.
Yeah, well, that figures.
But why?
Just to make sure I'd read the book. Oh, now really, Pam. You drag me in and out of murders, trap me into reading novels written by sweet little old ladies, and... Oh, I love you anyway.
Mr. and Mrs. North is directed by Ralph Francis Murphy, a John W. Loveton production. Produced by Federal Telefilms. Starring Barbara Britton and Richard Denning, featuring Francis DeSales. This has been a film presentation.